Good morning, dear students. Today we will start with a new chapter, that is chemical kinetics. It is one of the important chapter of physical chemistry. So whenever term kinetics is there, it is related with the movement or the motion. So how can we apply the term kinetics to chemistry? So whenever we talk about any chemical reaction, then in the chemical reaction, reactant gets converted to product. It means there is the movement of molecules from the reactant side to the product side. So term chemical kinetics can be applied to chemical reactions where reactants gets converted to product. There is the movement of the molecules from the reactant side to product side. Thermodynamics, again an important branch of chemistry, tells us about the feasibility of a chemical reaction under given set of physical conditions. Suppose you have provided temperature and pressure. At that temperature and pressure, by using thermodynamics principles, we can find out whether the reaction will be spontaneous or not, that the reaction will take place or not. So thermodynamics tells us about the feasibility of the reaction, whether the reaction will take place at a particular pressure and temperature or not. But it does not tell anything about the speed of the reaction, or we can say rate of the reaction. That's why one more branch of chemistry is required, which is called chemical kinetics. So definition of chemical kinetics: it is the branch of chemistry that deals with rate of reaction, their mechanism, and the factor affecting the rate of reaction. Now, one important term is there, which is called rate of reaction. So how to define rate of reaction? Whenever we talk about the chemical reaction, in the chemical reaction, reactant gets converted to products. It means concentration of reactant is changing with respect to time. Concentration of the reactant is changing with respect to time. So whenever any physical quantity is measured with respect to time or per unit time, then we can use the term rate. So how to define rate of reaction? It is change in concentration of reactant or product per unit time. With the passage of time, concentration of reactant decreases while concentration of product increases. So rate of reaction can be defined with respect to reactant, or it can be defined with respect to product. So it is change in concentration of reactant or product divided by time taken. Unit. First of all, remember, here we are using molarity as the concentration term, capital M. Unit for molarity is mole per liter. Time taken, in most of the cases, it is measured in second, So here, the second, so unit will be mole per liter per second. For mole per liter, we can also write capital M. So it can be M per second. So what is the rate of reaction? Change in concentration of reactant or product per unit time is called rate of reaction. If the rate of reaction is high, change in concentration of reactant with respect to time is more, then the reaction will be fast. And if rate of reaction is less, or we can say change in concentration of reactant with respect to time is less, then the nature of reaction will be slow reaction. Then comes the factors affecting rate of reaction. So here are five factors which affects the chemical reaction. First is nature of reactant, second is concentration of reactant, third is surface area of reactant, fourth is catalyst, and number fifth is temperature. Nature of reactants. You know it very well that sodium is a highly reactive matter. On the other hand, if we talk about fluorine, fluorine is also a highly reactive non-metal. So whenever reactive metals are taken with reactive non-metals, then reaction will be fast. And if less reactive metals are taken, then the reaction will be slow. So if metals are reactive or non-metals are reactive, then reaction will be fast. And if metals and non-metals used have less reactivity, then reaction will be slow. Then comes concentration of reactant. In most of the cases, it is seen that if we increase the concentration of the reactant, then rate of reaction will increase. So we can say here that rate of reaction is directly proportional to concentration of the reactant in most of the cases. Then we have third factor, surface area of the reactant. More the surface area of the reactant, more will be the rate of reaction. Whenever a solid gets converted into its powdered form, then powdered form is having more surface area than the solid form. It can be explained by the help of a very simple physical process. Try to dissolve sugar cube in water. Then, in the second case, convert the sugar cube into its powdered form. Dissolution of sugar, when taken in powdered form, is more easy if it is compared with the sugar cube. Because when the sugar cube is crushed into powdered form, most of the molecules of the sugar are exposed to water molecule. And if the sugar molecules are exposed to water molecule, then definitely dissolution process will be there. So whenever a solid form is converted into its powdered form, its surface area increases, as a result of which rate of reaction also increases. Then comes catalyst. You know it very well. Catalyst always speed up the chemical reaction. Catalyst always increases the rate of reaction. So if presence of catalyst is there, rate of reaction will be high, or we can say reactant will be converted to product in a very short time. Because catalyst provide an alternative path for the chemical reaction for which activation energy is low. So whenever a chemical reaction propagates through the path where activation energy is low, more reactant molecule will be converted into product molecule. So presence of catalyst increases the rate of reaction. Then comes temperature. In most of the cases, rate of reaction increases with the increase in temperature, because if we are increasing the temperature of the reactant molecule, then the molecules possessing activation energy, or we can say the fraction of molecules which possess activation energy, will increase. And if the fraction of the molecules increases which are having activation energy, then that reactant molecule will be converted into product molecule. So temperature in most of the cases increases the rate of reaction. Factor number 5, that is temperature, will be talked in detail in this chapter, because it is one of the most important factors which affects the rate of reaction. That's all for today. Thank you.